So last day we ended our discussion over here where we have seen that how we can declare a particular variable and what is the basic syntax of declaring a variable as well as initializing a variable with a value. And this is what that we have seen. These two are basically examples of the variable declaration and initialization some value, this part. And we have realized one thing, that the value that we are actually inserting in this variable, which is basically, you know, ultimately some memory location, then question is that among this range, if I consider the whole range of data from minus infinity to plus infinity, we must have some limit that up to something I can store in that particular variable, because we know that we cannot work with the memory location directly, because memory address is very complex, and as a programmer it is basically very impractical to work with memory address directly. That's why the compiler has given a facility to us, that it has given a option that we can call a memory address by a nickname, and that nickname technically we say a variable, like A or any other variable name. Now variable name has a specific syntax, we will discuss that later, but the philosophy of variable is something like that. So basically when you are writing A equal to 10, that means 10 is getting stored basically in some memory location. And as a programmer, really we don't know what is that address, exact address value. If we want, then we can find that. We can print that address from where the 10 is stored. But to work with in a programming environment, we don't require that particular memory address, because I have a variable that is representing that memory location. So this variable is basically an abstraction from a programmer point of view. Under the abstraction, you know, actually below the abstraction, what is present? The entire memory space. So using variable obviously has kept the working with data become easier. Now you see, the memory that we have is basically a finite amount of memory we have. It's not that I have infinite amount of memory, right? So if the memory is finite, that means the data that I can store in the memory must be finite. That means it is not possible to store plus infinity in a memory location, even minus infinity. It's not possible. I need some definite value up to which I can store. So that is actually defines the range. And we have assumed that suppose the negative value should be say up to minus n, and positive value maybe up to plus n. And that actually defines the range, minus n to plus n. So basically we have to realize this range for different data type we have. We will do it very soon. But before that, as we work with binary mathematics, all the data that computer deals with are binary numbers. To realize this range, or to derive the range for different data type, we have to learn one thing, that is what we call binary mathematics. So what is binary mathematics? Means all mathematical issues are binary numbers, as simple as that, right? So now if we consider mathematical issues, that means basic four mathematical operations we all know, that is addition, subtraction, division and multiplication, right? Now this multiplication and division is basically you can assume as say successive additions and successive subtraction. So that means the primitive two mathematical operations are actually addition and subtraction. So we have to learn how we can add two binary numbers, also how we can add two, I can subtract two binary numbers. So we will realize this one first. Suppose that we have two binary numbers, say A and B, and A is 1101 and B is 1011. If I want to add them, then what will be the result? This is my question. Now how we can do this? That means how we have to understand that what actually happens when I add 1 and 1. To do this, it's better if you are able to understand a simple table regarding this binary addition. If I have two binary bit x and y, a 1-bit binary number, you see, this A is not a 1-bit binary number, it is a 4-bit binary number, right? B is a 4-bit binary number. But I am assuming that x is 1-bit binary number and y is 1-bit binary number. And say f is the result. So if it happens, then what the table look like? So if we have two binary numbers 0 and 0. By the way, I have one more thing. Not only f is required, there are two more things should be there. Generally, we don't it consider as f, we consider as s. We consider as s, which represents sum. Okay, and another parameter c, which represents carry. Why sum and carry? You know, this sum and carry concept actually present in any addition. I mean, for example, if you say that, for example, you are adding say 2 plus 3, you do that 2 plus 3 actually equal to 5. You can do this, but you don't write anything more. But if I say that 7 plus 8, you say it's 15. What does it mean? It means actually 7 plus 8 means 15. And 15, then what you, why you write 5 over here? The reason is that 7 plus 8 is 15. But since 15 is not a single digit number, it's a combination of two digits. That's why in this place, the 5 that we that is came because of is the base. You know, the idea is that base minus, the result minus base, whatever will come will be on this particular bit. 7 plus 8 is 15, result is 15, minus base is, base of decimal number system is 10, right? We have seen in previous classes. Base of decimal number system is 10. We are working on decimal number system over here, right? So that means 15 minus 10 is equal to 5, and that's why 5 we put. And the one that we have over here is basically what we call carry, and this is actually what we call sum. But this situation will happen only when result will be greater than base. if result is less than base this, there is nothing to do. That means something like this. But here also I have one thing, that is carry. Here the carry is zero. What we don't write, because zero doesn't have any value if it is in the leftmost side, right? So that means each and this sum carry concept is present in any mathematical additions. So that means what will be the S and C over here? If the values are 0 and 0, the 1 bit data in X and 1 bit data in Y is 0 and 0, then the corresponding decimal of this X and Y will be 0. 0 in binary means 0 obviously in decimal. If you convert a binary 0 to decimal, it will be 0, right? So 0, 0 means 0. That means sum is 0. And if sum is 0, it is not exceeding the base. That's why obviously carry will be simply carry will be equal to 0. This is case 1, combination number 1. Combination number 2 can be 0, 1. That x is 0 and y is 1. If it happens, you see, the corresponding decimal of 0 is 0 and corresponding decimal of 1 is 1, right? That means basically you are adding 0 and 1 in decimal and ultimately you know result will be 1 without any carry, right? If the result is 1 in decimal, the corresponding binary of that will be 1 again, right? So that's why 0 and 1 sum is 1. But carry remains 0. This is case number 2. If I take another combination, just an inverted combination, like 1, 0, just the bit has been toggled, 0 become 1 and 1 becomes 0. So naturally the logic of sum and carry remains same. But the last one, a combination can be something like, why I'm saying last? Because this is the fourth combination and I have only 2 1 bit data. Number of combinations obviously will be 4, 2 to the power 2, because we are considering on binary numbers. We have already seen that. Anyway, so 1 in binary and this is also 1 in binary. If I convert this 1 and this 1 into corresponding decimal, they will be 1 again. Right, so in decimal if you add 1 and 1, okay, 1 and 1, then it's 2. This 2 means what? This 2 in decimal, but if you convert it to in binary, it will become 1 0. What is this? This is sum part. We have seen the last second this bit. That means sum is 0 and carry is 1. So this is the table you should remember. But one thing we have ignored over here. That is, we are not considering a previous carry. What does previous carry means? Previous carry means when you are adding say 2 plus 3, do you have any previous carry from the previous digits of the number? There is no previous digit. There is nothing in the right of 2. There is nothing in the right of 3. We always divide from the rightmost bit, right? So that means I can say that the previous carry for this addition is 0. I can write over here. For example, if you add two numbers, say 12 and say for example 29. when you are adding 9 plus 2, you are finding that it's 11, and 11 minus 10, that is equal to 1. That's why you put 1 over here, and the 1 you write over here, and that actually you add 2 plus 1 plus 1, that is equal to 4. This is the result, right? We know in this way, we do in this way. So if we have 1 representing previous carry because of this addition, that means what is previous carry in this case? Obviously 0, because there is nothing in the right hand side of 2 and right hand side of 3. This was the first rightmost digit. That means in this situation, the table up to this 4 column, 4 rows, we have considered for each and every case, we have considered previous carry is basically 0. Previous carry is 0. But what if previous carry become 1, then what will happen? Like if I continue with this result, let's write one by one the other situations possible. Say one, another 4 combination I have to consider for previous carry 1, right? Something like this, where we have the same combination will repeat 0 0 0 1 and 1 0 1 1. And here the previous carry is 1. So we have to take into account that. We have to understand this. That I have 0 over sum. Fine. This sum should be added with this previous carry. So 0 plus 1. So that I cannot write 0. If it is 1, I should write 1. But carry remains 0, right? Because 0 plus 1 means 1, that's all. Similarly, in case of 0, 1, the sum is 1 when previous carry was 0. But if previous carry was 1, then this 1 has to be added with this 1. That means 1 plus 1 become 2. If 1 plus 1 become 2, 2 means actually you found 1, 0, where 0 is sum. So that means here 0 will be, sum will be 0 and carry become 1. You see, the combination for 0, 1 has been changed because I have previous carry 1. Similarly, similar situation will arise for this case because it's just toggled. 0, 1 become 1, 0 and previous carry 1 is 1 again. That means here also I will have 0, 1. An interesting thing happened over here, you see. In case of 1, 1, we have seen that sum is 0, carry become 1, fine. Now, when previous carry was 0, that was okay. But when previous carry is 1, then this 0 should be added with this 1. So 0 and 1 means 1. So that means 1. But carry remain 1, right? Carry is not changing. So this is the entire table that will reflect a binary addition of only 1 bit. X is of 1 bit data, Y is of 1 bit data, and previous carry is of 1 bit data. And then the sum and the corresponding next carry will be something like this, which may be forwarded for the other bits. If the binary numbers that I am adding is a multiple bit number, something like A and B that is shown over here. And if you closely watch this table, I don't think the understanding or remembering this table is very difficult. The reason is that you see, basically, if you consider only this 3 part, is the input, at least you can say, right? Previous carry X and Y is the input and sum and carry is the output. You can assume in this way. And you see, there are obviously 3 different bits. Each and every bit having 2 different options. That's why 2 to the power 3, total 8 combinations possible. Like you see, I have total 8 combinations. This is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. So 0 to 7 means 8, total 8 combinations. Fine. Among these 8 combinations, you see, I have a specific thing that I can notice in this sum and carry part, that when in this combination all are 0, then sum and carry is 0. When in this combination have exactly one numerical 1 is present, then the sum is 1 and carry is 0. You see, for example, in this case, 0, 0, 1. Only 1, 1 is present, that's why 1, 0. 0, 1, 0, similar thing. Similarly, 1, 0, 0, similar thing. Similarly, nothing more than present. Now, if in this 3 combination, there are 2, 1 present, 2, in 2 position have 1, then the output is 0, 1. I mean, sum is 0, carry is 1. For example, say something like 3, this particular row, 0, 1, 1. I have 2 numerical 1, that's why output is sum is 0, carry is 1. I have 2 numerical 1 in 5, 1 and 1 over here, but 0 in this case. That's why again, 0, 1. Similarly for 6, 1 and 1, but third bit is 0, that's why 0 and 1. But if there is 3, all the bits are 1, like this one, then only the sum and carry both are 1. So there are actually 3 different situations. All 0, sorry, not 3, actually 4 different possibilities. All are 0, only one position have 1, other two position have 0, any other two position. Only one position have 0, any other two position have 1, and all the position have 1. These are the 4 categories. And for these 4 categories, the combinations are, you can easily find out from this table. And if you are able to remember this particular table, you know, then your binary addition will be easier. For example, if I want to add this situation, what will be the result for this case? You see, as I told you that initial carry is always we consider 0, right? That means here initial carry is 0. Now assume only this part. As a binary addition only of this part, 0, 1 and 1, you see, 0, 1, 1 and 1, where? 0, 1, 1. This combination is present over here. So 0, 1, 1 for input, the sum is 0 and carry is 1, so I can blindly write sum is 0 and carry is 1. So carry is 1 means this 1 will be forwarded over here. The carry 1 that I found over here will be forwarded over here, so that it can be used for the next addition. A simple approach that actually we follow for simple addition on decimal numbers also, right? Because the strategy will never change. Although the number system may change, for example, I can work with decimal, I can work with octal or maybe hexadecimal, but strategy of addition subtraction will never change, right? Now, this combination is again 101. So again, let's see, 101 is situation is like this. This one, 101, right? 101 means sum 0, carry 1. Again, so that means sum 0 and carry is 1. Again, I will have something like another separate 3 single bit addition. Addition of 3 single bits, you can assume 110, so it's 110. 110 means again 01. So again, sum is 0 and carry is 1. And again, separately, I can assume this part. And what is this combination? It is 111. So the last one, basically, which is sum is 1, carry is 1. That means sum will be 1 and carry you can write, but there is nothing bit left, that way you can carry right the carry over here. So this is your result. Now if you want to check whether you are correct or not, you can easily find it, whether it is following the decimal number systems. What I mean that if you convert this bit A in decimal and convert B in decimal and then you add, you will get a decimal addition result, and Similarly, if you convert this 11000 in decimal, then you will find a decimal number. If they are same, that means it's correct. So for example, 1101, you can find it, you know, if you try in your home, you can easily do this. This is what I can say in decimal. It is decimal. It is 1101 means 8 plus 5 13. How fast and why and how fast I'm actually doing, you can easily do this. You need a little bit practice, that's all. 1011, it's again, it's basically 11, okay, in decimal. So 13 plus 11, it means what? It means 13 plus 10, 23, 24, right? So if I find 24's binary, then let's see what will happen. 2 12 24 0 2 6 12 0 2 3 6 0 2 1 2 remainder 1 2 0 0 remainder 1. So 0 is there, you cannot proceed. I should write in this form, just on opposite order. What I will find out? 11000, right? Exactly what I got in the result part over here. That means the addition process was correct, and that's why the result that I'm getting in binary is actually parallel to the result that I will get if I consider the same thing in case of decimal. So this is an approach of a binary addition of multiple bits numbers.